Welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to discuss about the T and pi representation of the two-port network. Okay. So in previous videos, we discussed the various parameters in order to analyze the two-port network and the relationship between the different parameters. And what about the interconnection of the two-port network? So all these things we discussed. If you want to learn all videos related to the circuit analysis in my channel, in the name of circuit analysis, one playlist is there. In that playlist, all videos, lecture videos are available from Ohm's law to this. Okay, so from unit 1 to unit 5, all videos are available, as well as the important 2-mark question and answer. Okay, so this is also solved in that video. If you want to learn that videos, I will give link for the playlist in the description box. You can refer it. Okay. So now we will discuss about our topic T and pi representation. Okay. So usually in communication system, generally all networks such as transmission line, various electronic filters, attenuators, etc., can be represented in terms of two-port network. In terms of two-port network parameter, that is, in order to analyze all our communication system blocks like transmission line, communication filters and attenuators. So each network we are considering as a two-port network, and in order to analyze and design that particular network, we are using the two-port network parameter like Z parameter, transmission line parameter, H parameter, and so on. Okay, and there are two different format of the two-port network is that one structure is T structure, another one is pi structure. Okay, so T means in the shape of the capital T, the elements are connected. Okay, then pi means in the shape of pi. Okay, the elements are connected means that shape of network is called as T-type network and pi-type network. And the T-type and pi-type networks are equivalent to each other. Okay, we can convert T network into pi network and pi network into T network. Okay, so what about the how to convert it, and what is the relation between the Z parameter and the T-type impedance value we are going to discuss. Okay, and if so for some network, if we are having the set of open circuit impedance parameter, that is Z parameter. The Z parameter, you know, the Z parameter is called as a open circuit impedance parameter of any network. You know, means we can represent that particular network by equivalent T network. Okay. If you know for one two-port network, if you know the open circuit impedance parameter means we can draw that particular two-port network in the form of a T structure. Okay, similarly, if we have a set of short circuit admittance parameter, that is Y parameter, means we can represent that network by a equivalent pi network. Okay, so in the shape of pi network, we can connect it. Okay, and this thing is applicable for all reciprocal network. Okay. So already we discussed in the previous videos, we discussed reciprocity and symmetrical condition for the two-port network. Okay, so if one network, it satisfies the reciprocity theorem, means it is called as a reciprocal network. That is, for example, in terms of Z parameter, if Z12 and 21 value is equal, means that two-port network is called as a reciprocal network. Similarly, in terms of Y parameter, means if Y12 and Y21 values are equal, means that two-port network is called as a reciprocal network. So for that reciprocal network, we can represent either pi structure or T structure. Okay. So in this video, we are going to discuss about the how to draw the T-type network and a related problem we are going to discuss. In the next video, we will discuss about the pi network. Okay. So the first one, the equivalent T network of two-port reciprocal network we are going to discuss. Okay, so for that, we have to consider one linear passive two-port reciprocal network. Okay, so you just consider one two-port network. That network is a linear network, passive network, and reciprocal network. Okay, so if this linear passive two-port reciprocal network, we can draw the equivalent diagram of this two port reciprocal network in the type of T structure. Okay, so this is the equivalent T network of our two port reciprocal network. So in this T network, you see the three elements. The impedance ZA, ZB, and ZC is connected in the shape capital T. That's why this network is called as a T-type network. So this is the equivalent network of our given two-port reciprocal network. And you just consider this is the input port 1-1 dash, and this is the output port 2-2 dash. Okay, and just you mark the input voltage is V1, input current is I1, output current is I2, and output voltage is V2, you just consider. Okay, then if the current flowing through this ZA is I1, and current flowing through this ZB is I2, means what is the current flowing through this center impedance ZC? It's addition of I1 plus I2. Okay, so you just note down this one. So now we are going to find the relation between this impedance ZA, ZB, ZC in terms of the impedance parameter Z11, 12, 21, and 22. Okay, so we are going to relate this T network impedance with the Z parameter Z11, 12, 21, and 22. Okay, so for that, first we have to, as per the definition of the Z parameter, you write down the Z parameter equation. What is the Z parameter equation? The V1 equal to Z11 I1 plus Z12 I2. Similarly, the output voltage V2 equal to Z21 I1 plus Z22 I2. These two equations are call it as a Z parameter equation. Okay, then this Z parameter of the equivalent T network is shown in figure B. Okay, so already this is the figure B. So for this figure B, we are going to write the KVL equation for the input loop, output loop separately. We can get two more equation. Okay, so you just write KVL for this input loop. If you are writing KVL for input loop, V1 equal to I1 into ZA plus ZC into I1 plus I2. So you see V1 equal to ZA I1 plus ZC into I1 plus I2. So you collect the I1 term. So if you are collecting, this is one I1 term, this is one I1 term, means ZA plus ZC into I1 plus ZC I2. So you consider this is the equation number 3. Similarly, we have to write one more KVL equation for the second loop. So if you are writing V2 equal to I2 into ZB plus I1 plus I2 into ZC. Okay, so you see V2 equal to ZB into I2 plus ZC into I1 plus I2. So you collect I1 term separately, I2 term separately, we can get the V2 equation like this. This is the V1 equation. Okay, so now from the equivalent T network, we formed two equation, V1 in terms of I1, I2, V2 in terms of I1, I2. Okay, and we have to compare this V1 and V2 equation with our standard Z parameter equation. So this is the Z parameter equation, you know, V1 in terms of I1, I2, V2 in terms of I1, I2. If you are comparing this equation of 1 and 2 with this 3 and 4, we can get what is this ZA plus ZC. This ZA plus ZC is said to be Z11. What is this ZC? Z12. This ZC, Z21. The ZB plus ZC equal to Z22. So by comparing that two thing, we can get this is the relation. Okay, so you see, this is the Z parameter of two port network. This is the T network elements. Okay, so Z parameter in terms of the T network element we calculated. So what is Z11? It is addition of ZA and ZC. So you see this our equivalent T structure. Okay, so in this equivalent T structure, the addition of this two value, the addition of ZA and ZC is said to be Z11. The addition of ZB and ZC is said to be Z22. And this ZC, this common element, this is called as a Z12 or Z21. Okay, so we can relate that values. So from that, you see, this is the relation between Z parameter and the equivalent T network values. Okay, similarly, so we can write the Z parameter. Z11, 12, 21, 22, we can replace it with what is Z11, ZA plus ZC. What is Z12, ZC? What is Z21, ZC? What is Z22, ZB plus ZC? Okay, we can write. Then if you are rearranging, so this is a Z parameter in terms of T network element. So from that, the T network element we can relate in terms of the Z parameter value. Okay, so from that, Z12 equal to ZC. So if you are substituting instead of ZC, if you are substituting Z12, means we can get ZA equal to Z11 minus 12. Okay, so you see the ZA value is calculated by subtracting Z12 from Z11. Similarly, ZB is nothing but we can subtract Z12 from Z22. And ZC is nothing but which is equal to Z12, which is equal to Z21. Okay, so these are all the T network element in terms of Z parameter. Okay, so using this, we are going to solve the problem. Okay, so you may get problem related with this. Okay, so either there may be given Z parameter, you just, we have to draw the T type network. Or the T type network given, you just find the Z parameter. Okay, there are two types of problem is there. Okay, so from that, the T equivalent T network, we have to replace the value. Is that A is nothing but Z11 minus Z12. Is that B is nothing but Z22 minus Z12. Is that C is nothing but which is equal to 12 and 21. Okay, so this is the equivalent T network. Okay, so now we are going to solve the problem. You see the problem. The impedance matrix of the T network is 40, 5, 5 and 10. Find the circuit elements. Okay, so the impedance matrix of the T network. So for one T network, the Z parameter, impedance matrix means Z matrix is given. So what is this 40? It's a Z11. What is this 5? It's a Z12. What is this 5? Z21. And this 10 is Z22. Okay, so the Z parameter is given. We have to obtain ZA, ZB, ZC, the T-type network we have to, T-type network element we have to find out. Okay, so from the given data, you just note down the thing, Z11 is 40, then Z1221, both are equal. Since this T-type equivalent network, we have to draw it for reciprocal network only. Okay, so if one network is a reciprocal network, Z12 and 21 value both are equal. And Z22 is 10 ohms. Okay, so you note down the thing first. Then we know that the impedances in T network. Okay, so we have to find out from using this Z1122 value, we have to find the impedance in T network. ZA, ZB, ZC. Okay, so just now we derived ZA, ZB, ZC value in terms of impedance parameter. Okay, so you know the formula. What is ZA? ZA is nothing but Z11 minus Z12. Okay, so what is Z11? Z11 is 40 and Z12 is 50. So Z11 minus Z12, if you are subtracting, we can get 35 ohms. Similarly, ZB is nothing but Z22 minus Z12. So Z22 is 10. So 10 minus 5, 5. And ZC is nothing but Z12, which is 5. So we calculated the T network elements. Okay, then you just draw the T network and you just replace it. What is the value of ZA? 35 ohms. ZB is 5 ohms. ZC is also 5 ohms. Okay, so the T network elements are calculated. Okay, so this is the procedure in order to find out the circuit element if Z parameter is given. Okay, so reverse for this question. Okay, there is another one problem is that if ZA, ZB, ZC given means the question is to we have to form the impedance matrix. Okay, so if ZA 35, ZB 5, ZC 5 means, so the question, if they are asking construct the impedance matrix means, so the impedance matrix is constructed by what is Z11. Okay, so as per our thing, the Z11 is nothing but Z11 equal to ZA plus ZC. Z1221 equal to ZC. Z22 equal to ZB plus ZC. Okay. So from that, so you see, ZA plus ZC, 35 plus 5, 40. It's a Z11. ZB plus ZC, 5 plus 5, 10. It is a Z22. Then this ZC is a Z12 value. Okay, so in reverse also you may get the problem. Okay, so this is the method in order to find the T network element from the impedance matrix. Okay, so similar to this, in next video we are going to construct the equivalent pi network for the two port network using Y parameter. Okay, so we will discuss in the next video. So thanks for watching my channel, and please subscribe my channel for more videos. If you want to learn all videos, lecture videos related with the circuit analysis in my channel, in the name of circuit analysis, the complete playlist is there. In that I solved maximum and last 10 year and university question paper. Okay, so if you want to learn, I will give link in the description box, you can refer it. Okay, so thank you, we will meet in the next video.